By now, everybody knows Justin Bieber took to social media last week and revealed that he is suffering from facial paralysis due to Ramsay Hunt Syndrome.
As you can probably see from my face, I have Ramsay Hunt Syndrome, and it is from this virus that attacks the nerve in my ear, my facial nerves.
Now, Ramsay Hunt is a very rare disease and occurs in 5 in 100,000 people. It's a disease that is caused by the reactivation of the chickenpox virus called zoster that lies dormant in the facial nerve. Now, when I was a kid, I got chickenpox. My sisters got it. I got it. In fact, parents used to take kids for chickenpox parties so that they could all get it and recover from it. When that happens, the virus lies dormant in the nerves all throughout the body. If you haven't had chickenpox before, or if you have a child, you have the option to get the chickenpox vaccine. Now, if you're older than 50 like me, and shingles becomes a bigger risk in someone who has had a history of chickenpox, you could consider the shingles vaccine. That will help prevent the painful rash that you get, and that is a great way to prevent reactivation of this virus, which can lead to Ramsay Hunt syndrome.
As you can see, this eye is not blinking. I can't smile on this side of my face. This nostril will not move. So there's full paralysis in this side of my face.
Now, the facial nerve is a large nerve, and we have one on each side of our face. The main root comes out somewhere back here behind the ear and the jaw, and it gives off 5 different branches to the face. Each one of those branches supplies all of the muscles that make our face work. Now, Ramsay Hunt syndrome is specifically caused by the herpes zoster virus. And then what happens to the nerve is there's a ganglia, or a swelling in the nerve, that becomes more swollen and cuts off the blood supply. When the blood supply to the nerve is compromised, you have the motor deficits that we're seeing here in Justin's face.
I wish this wasn't the case, but obviously my body's telling me I gotta slow down. I'll be using this time to just rest and relax and get back to 100%.
So how do we treat Ramsay Hunt syndrome? There are 2 main medications that I want to talk about here. The first medication is called acyclovir, which is an antiviral medication. We give that medication and it helps to suppress the virus, therefore hoping to decrease the symptoms that anyone may be having. The second medication that we use is a steroid called prednisone. Steroids are robust anti-inflammatory medications, and they can help to decrease the inflammation like Justin might be suffering in the nerve itself. So take a look at this picture right here. There are several things going on that we need to address. The issue with the inability to close the eye, he also points towards the corner of his mouth where you can get some drooping there, and he also points to his nose where you can clearly see that his nostril is not expanding normally. So how do we help Justin and other patients protect their cornea from drying out and getting ulcers, which can be very devastating to their sight? The first thing that people can do, which is the most obvious thing, is to use lubricating eye drops or ointments to prevent drying of the cornea. The second thing that can be done is to just wear a patch which covers the eye, and that will also help to prevent any drying out of the cornea. If they don't have a patch or they don't have ointment, you could simply find some tape and you can tape the eyelid shut at nighttime, because while they're sleeping, the one eye that's affected will not close.
It will go back to normal. It's just time, and we don't know how much time that's gonna be.
Now, what happens if he has prolonged disease of this nerve and his eye won't close for months on end? Well, I discussed how to fix this in my social media posting last week, where I talked about taking a gold weight to help the upper eyelid close. Now, in some patients who've had tumor resections in the brain and they have permanent injury to the nerve, we know that they will never be able to close their eyelid. And so the way that we help them close their eyelid is, if you look here, I'll show you a picture of these little gold weights that we use. Once we've determined the right weight, we make a small incision just like we do for an eyelid lift. We undermine the skin and we suture the gold weight to the inside of the eyelid, and we close the skin on top. That way, whenever the person initiates closing the eye, the weight will help the eyelid shut. All right, so the other 2 things that Justin was talking about and pointing to were that the nostril was collapsed and the corner of the mouth was kind of sagging. Now, there's a couple of problems here. Number one, there's not enough muscle tone in the cheek, and so the inside of the cheek can hang inside of the mouth and you can chronically bite it, which can be really painful and be a huge problem. The second thing is the corner of the mouth can droop enough such that they drool out of the mouth. For the nose, it's obvious if the nostrils collapse, they can't really breathe out of it. So what are some things that we could do reconstructively to help fix those problems? Now, luckily for Justin and most other people that have Ramsay Hunt syndrome, they're never gonna have to go through what I'm about to talk about. There's surgery called reanimation surgery, which means reanimating the face. One way to do that is some microsurgeons will take a free flap or tissue from one part of the body with a nerve, an artery, and a vein. They suture the muscle under the skin of the face. They attach one limb to the eye, one to the nose, and one to the mouth. They sew the nerves, the arteries, and the veins together so that the patient actually regains function of those muscles and can try to control the eye, the nose, and the corner of the mouth. Now, if a patient doesn't want to go through that huge, drastic microvascular procedure, we can then do something which is called a facial sling. We take the palmaris longus tendon from the hand, which you don't need, it has no function really. We take that tendon and we can make a small incision in the back here by the jaw. We tunnel the tendon underneath the skin and we can split it at the end and sew one half to the corner of the mouth and one half to the nostril. We then pull back on that tendon to pull up on the corner of the mouth and to pull the side of the nose out and suture it down to the zygoma bone. And we close the skin over the top and so they have chronically pulled up corner of the mouth and side of the nose.
It's all for a reason. And I'm not sure what that is right now, but in the meantime, I'm gonna rest and I love you guys.
So Justin, we're all wishing you a speedy recovery and anyone else who might be suffering from this syndrome. The hope is that your doctor, as well as other people's doctors, act fast to get them the steroids and the antiviral medications they need to help minimize the risk of having the symptoms that you're having. We wish you a speedy recovery, and I really, really know and hope that over time, this is gonna resolve very quickly because I am a believer. Okay, my friends, I hope you guys learned something in this video that gave you some really good education and insight to Ramsay Hunt syndrome. Leave some comments below, and if you have questions, I will try my best to get to them and answer them. But for now, Dr. Ricky, out.